हाय फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज चैतन्य भटकेन। वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। एज यू कैन इमेजिन मेकिंग दिस वीडियो, आई एम वेरी अपसेट, वेरी सैड, बट दैट्स हाउ थिंग्स गो समटाइम्स। अनफॉर्चुनेटली यू माइट हैव हर्ड द न्यूज़ दैट वीवो IPL 2021 सीजन 14 हैज़ बीन कैंसल्ड इनडेफिनेटली ड्यू टू द COVID-19 पैंडेमिक, एंड द टीम्स ऑफ फोर प्लेयर्स गॉट इन्फेक्टेड, देर ट्रेनर्स एज वेल, देर कोचेस एज वेल। So, it was the best decision, I think, because the safety of players are paramount. It's paramount, and the tournament can be completed anyway at the later stages. But the lives of players are very important, very essential, and should be of primary concern. And well done to BCCI for thinking on that lines. Of course, there are going to be some repercussions. We are going to discuss this as per the report in the Times of India. I have the paper because a long list of consequences have befallen the BCCI. But they took a nice decision, as I mentioned some moments earlier, because if players are healthy, players are fine, and if they are not in a state of mind to continue in the tournament, we shouldn't be forced. And you can imagine the quality of cricket will go down immensely if they play in such sort of mindset and mentality. Plus, it is not a question of that. The lives of players, as I said, is very important, and well done to BCCI once again. Now we will look at the consequences of this decision. There are huge consequences. First of all, we will take a look at the statement of Mr. Brijesh Patel. He is the IPL chairman. He said that we will send them home and we will find a way to do that. Brijesh Patel said when asked about the foreigners, but he did not elaborate because as you know, many countries have put travel ban on their citizens returning from India, or many countries have made compulsory rules of hard institutional quarantine once they arrive from India. It may be of 7 days, 10 days or 14 days, that varies according to the country. The foreigners are worried over their return due to travel restrictions imposed in the wake of deadly resurgence of the pandemic in India. The BCCI has assured them of a safe return as well. Now we will take a look at the players. The number of foreigners playing in the IPL: 14 Australian players, 10 from New Zealand, 11 from England, South Africa also 11, 9 from West Indies, 3 from Afghanistan and 2 from Bangladesh. So these are the foreigners that took part in the IPL this season. Now we will take a look at the statement of Cricket Australia. Cricket Australia and the Australian Cricketers Association said that they respect the government's decision to suspend flights operating out of India due to COVID-19 surge, and he will not seek exemption for the players. As you know, it is the directive by the Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison that citizens are not allowed, and at least till May 15, that is Australian citizens from India. Cricket Australia is in direct contact with the BCCI as they work through the plans to ensure the safe accommodation and repartition of Australian players, coaches, match officials, commentators took back home to Australia. Cricket Australia and Australia Cricketers Association respect the decision of the Australian government to pause travel from India at least May 15 and will not seek exemptions. So the players have to do it on their own, and in all likelihood BCCI will take care of that, because the arrangements of BCCI are world class. Even though some time will go before they make their arrangements, rest of the cricketers be assured that you will reach your loved ones very safely. They further stated, Cricket Australia and the ACA thank the BCCI for their efforts and cooperation for the repartition of all participants at the IPL. Now we will take a look at the reaction of the South African Cricket Board. It will contact it is in contact with its players who need to home quarantine on the arrival from India as per World Health Organization's recommendations. Those travelling back to South Africa will undergo home quarantine in line with the current World Health Organization recommendations, it is said in a release. Cricket Australia and South African Cricketers Association are in contact with all the players and assured of their safety and comfort of their respective localization. Now we will take a look at the reaction of the New Zealand Cricket Board, which quite enjoys a healthy rapport and good relationship with the BCCI. New Zealand Cricket expressed faith in BCCI's ability to handle the situation. The statement is as follows: the players are in a relatively safe environment and those within affected teams are in isolation, read a New Zealand statement posted by ESPN Cricinfo. will continue to liaise with the BCCI, the English Cricket Board, and New Zealand government authorities in terms of managing the situation, but at the same juncture, it's too early to discuss potential options. India and New Zealand players were supposed to travel together in a chartered flight. That was the plan, but it is now cancelled, of course. To the UK, where they will clash in the World Test Championship final in June, which is going to take place at Southampton because due to the COVID-19 pandemic, it was shifted from Lord's Cricket Ground. So I need to assure or give message to all the foreign players that please have faith in the capabilities of BCCI. It is the best organization in the world and certainly by far the best organization in India. They will make sure that each and every one of you will reach your loved ones and nobody will be left stranded in their country, in India that is. And after the mandatory completion of rules of quarantine, they will once again be aligned with their families. So no worries at all. And yesterday, Rajiv Shukla also gave a statement while talking to Star Sports that IPL has been postponed, but it has not been cancelled. And so that is a good news, but I think in the next 2-3 months it is going to be very difficult, but he said be rest assured that the season will be completed. Now the next topic is BCCI set to incur huge losses. It stands to lose around rupees 2000 crore because half of the tournament is over, 29 matches are over out of 60. And the biggest loss is from Star Sports, of course. So Stars India, as you know, or some people, beg your pardon, might don't know, that has a contract of rupees 16,347 rupees crore rupees, which is 3,269.4 CR per year. If there are 60 games in a season, it approximates to rupees 54.5 crore per match. So in all likelihood, the calculation is as follows. In 29 matches, the Star Sports has almost played rupees 1,580 CR. This means there is a loss of BCCI of rupees 1,690 crore. Similarly, mobile manufacturers Vivo, as tournament title sponsor, pay rupees 440 crore per season, and BCCI is likely to guess less than half an amount. Of course, that is given in this situation because of the postponement. And add to it, there are many associate sponsors and companies like An Academy, Dream 11, CRED, Upstox, Tata Motors, who pay in the range of rupees 120 CR each per season. Some subsidiary sponsors are also there, as you know. Slash all the payments by half or a bit less, and you will be reaching a loss in the range of rupees 2,200 crore. The actual losses could be much more, but this is a back of the hand calculation for the season. One BCCI official told on the condition of anonymity. The loss of a substantial amount of money will also reduce the central revenue for the season. The money for which the BCCI distributes among 8 franchises to nearly half. That is also given that the season is now almost postponed, but not cancelled. I repeat once again. The official, however, didn't divulge how much each franchise would lose due to the suspension of the tournament. It is difficult to say what kind of sponsorship and co-sponsorship money they earned this season, as the economic climate has been pretty hostile. So there you go. There is a headline in Times of India as well that COVID clean bowls IPL. High profile league suspended indefinitely after multiple cases in bio bubble. So I think we'll stop here. We will meet in the next video, the Marathi video, and it is going to be the last of this season as the IPL has been postponed. I will continue to post videos on my other views and thoughts on cricket. That is basically some people have again been found guilty of corruption, and my all-time 11, rest of the video, so what I like about cricket. So that is going to be some extra stuff, but this is the penultimate video related to IPL 2021. So please enjoy, like, share, subscribe to my channel, and press the bell icon for further notification. And please tell your thoughts in the comment section below. And request once again before I leave, stay home, stay safe, take care everyone, and bye.